In this video today, we will take a look into the other MonsterVerse titans and which side will they be on if there was ever kind of a Godzilla vs. Kong civil war. Of course, the movie will feature the two titans battling each other for dominance and other reasons, but what about the other super species that exist alongside them? It wouldn't be great to say that they would not even be appearing in the movie. At least some of the older titans, and even the new ones that haven't had any screen time, should be shown in the upcoming movie. Behemoth has a leaked toy image that would most probably mean that he would be there in the movie, and so would Warbat and the Hellhawks. So let's dig in and dive into the probable allegiances the other titans will have in this battle of the superpowers. Let's do it. So titans are ancient gigantic creatures studied by the scientific organization known as Monarch. While Monarch initially designates any such creature it studies as massive, unidentified terrestrial organisms, once they are formally identified, they are then classified as titans. Many of these titans respond to an alpha, a titan which has cemented itself as the strongest of the creatures, typically by defeating the previous alpha. As of 2019, there are 19 titans discovered by Monarch. There are two types, the protector titans and the destroyers. In the end of KOTM, Scylla, Behemoth, Methuselah, Rodan and the Queen Muto arrive and bow down to Godzilla as their new alpha. And as the film ends, news clippings show a newly discovered Mothra egg, titans beginning to converge to Skull Island, a mysterious forest blooming at the Sahara Desert, and ancient paintings displaying Godzilla battling Kong. So there's a lot we need to catch up on the titans in this upcoming movie. Don't worry, we will get to the topic at hand. First, we need to cement ourselves in MonsterVerse lore. See, why this question arises is that Kong was never seen heeding the calls of either Ghidorah or Godzilla, and he is in his own way an alpha, the king of Skull Island. And since in the end of the movie we see news clippings that the titans are heading off to Skull Island, this doesn't seem to be just a coincidence. Titans aren't savages animals that just live to eat and eat to live. They are sentient creatures that have existed for hundreds of millions of years. And if you compound all that time into a near immortal monster, it would have the unspoken wisdom and intelligence of the ages. Which now leads me to a relatively new born Kong and his new alpha status. This might explain the reason as to why the titans are going off to Skull Island. Kong is relatively new on the world stage, but his ancestors were not. And it is now confirmed that there was an ancient battle between the members of Kong and Godzilla species. These titans now sense the presence of a new Alpha Kong individual, one that is capable of standing up against Godzilla. I will say it again, the titans bowed down to an alpha, and since they didn't really resist the call of Ghidorah, it means that they weren't too keen on joining sides with Godzilla either. There could have been major titan politics back in the day when the war between Kongs and Gojiras took place. Some might have gone to Kong's camp while others to Godzilla's, and others might have been neutral. Could this hint on a major titan battle thousands of years ago? This would be a prelude to the events of Godzilla vs. Kong. Since they have already hinted at monster wars that would be the foundation of this movie, let's see the synopsis once again, the new updated one by Legendary and Warner Bros. Here's what it says.
Legends collide in Godzilla vs. Kong as these mythic adversaries meet in a spectacular battle for the ages, with the fate of the world hanging in the balance. Kong and his protectors undertake a perilous journey to find his true home, but they unexpectedly find themselves in the path of an enraged Godzilla, cutting a swath of destruction across the world. The epic clash between the two titans, instigated by unseen forces, is only the beginning of a mystery that lies deep within the core of the earth.
What did I tell you? Okay, so let's see which titans would most definitely be on Godzilla's side. First one, Methuselah. This titan is first of all a reptilian kaiju that was discovered in Germany. He bowed down to Godzilla in King of the Monsters and has no specific loyalty to any other kaiju but the Alpha. Second, Scylla. As an aquatic kaiju that shares the habitat with Godzilla, it wouldn't be wise at all to challenge Godzilla, especially with his dominance of the seas and being isolated from the other camp. It would be an easy kill for the G-Man, therefore, Scylla would most probably side with Godzilla. Third, Warbat. As was seen in the trailer of Godzilla vs. Kong, the Warbats were hostile towards Kong and most probably his species. so it would make sense that it would be with Godzilla in any such battle. The Skullcrawlers, of course, are enemies of Kong, and just by that they would be on the team of Godzilla. Now going to the other corner, Kong's team of titans would consist of firstly the Muto Queen, since it is an ancient rival species of Godzilla, and although it bowed down to him in the end of King of the Monsters, it would most likely change sides in the case of a battle that has a challenging titan, since the death of Godzilla at the end of the battle would allow it to lay her spores inside him, and therefore create a new generation of Mutos that would take over the world. Secondly, Behemoth, another titan that was seen bowing down to Godzilla as Alpha, but the producers originally had a different backstory for this mammoth sloth giant. He was supposed to be a war beast that was chained up and shackled by an ancient society and used to go to war. That's the meaning of a war beast. And the cute part of this backstory is that it likes belly rubs and being groomed by Kong. So mammalian titans unite, I guess. Now let's go to the third camp, the neutral titans, which is like the non-alignment movement during the Cold War. Okay, Mothra's hatchling, firstly, if it was ever to come out in the future of the MonsterVerse, would definitely not take any sides, even though it was said that this creature, this titan, shares a symbiotic link with Godzilla. But I think Mothra's existence is to deter and fight against destroyer titans and threats to the planet, like Ghidorah. Kong, as a protector titan himself, would not be viewed with hostility by Mothra, which is why it would sit this one out. Secondly, Rodan, the fire demon, will not be joining any sides or sharing any allegiances to any of the two protector titans, since it is a destroyer. It will also be missing from either camps, and he was supposedly able to challenge other alpha titans in the original storyline, and since his loyalty is deemed questionable at the least, Starscream, this flying kaiju would most definitely be roosting over another volcano and watching Netflix instead of joining in another war. Although he could challenge Kong, however, in the future, if Kong was ever to beat Godzilla, which would be a great idea for a movie, Kong vs. Rodan. So I know that this isn't a perfect list of the titans that would side with either Kong or Godzilla. Therefore, you can put down your own list down in the comments section below. Make it a descriptive list that will describe which titans will side with who and why. And so with that, we come to the end of this video. Do like for support, smash that subscribe button, and also slap that notification bell for regular updates. Till the next one, take care, fam.